evening. What's your name, sir?
My name is John Courtney.
Where are you from?
I live in a village called Mosley, which is near Manchester.
Oh, OK. Have you brought anyone with you?
I've got my wife and two boys, I hear.
Brilliant. How long have you played the piano?
Since I was about five, I guess.
And is that how you make a living?
Yeah.
So is this the biggest venue you've performed in?
Yeah. The Palladium is like the Holy Grail to me. I used to watch the shows with my dad, and this is the home of variety.
Oh.
Overwhelming. It's amazing.
Oh, he's so happy.
Good luck, John.
Thank you. This is bonkers.
There was a man who had a dream that Simon Cowell and his team would watch him play piano and try to slay them on the stage of the Palladium. And in the time that one song took, David would write another book. Alicia would smile at him, Amanda would be kind to him, Simon's teeth would be blinding him if he was smiling. But nothing now could ever spoil the dream he dreamed like Susan Boyle.
I like this already. Yes, John.
Let's see if we haven't been in it
fact
yet.
Fact is, he never thought he'd ever get to be in front of millions of people doing his thing on TV. 30 years of playing in piano bars and pubs, dodging glasses when they're thrown, being thrown out of clubs. When your children ask, Daddy, when you're coming home, this game is not the same when you're just Daddy on the phone. So he sits at the piano and he tries to get prepared, thinking he'll write it in third person so he doesn't feel as scared to sing about himself to a bunch of strangers in the dark. But then Britain has got talent and he wants to make his mark. Paul Potts won the first year and said it was insane. The second year, George Sampson won, Singing in the Rain. Lost Voice Guys season 12, and last year, Colin Thackeray. So why not me?
Why not you?
That's what he said. His youngest boy, one night in bed, Dad, why not you? Go and show them what you do. And even though you'll be a wreck, at least you'll meet Anton Deck.
Ah, we made it!
Yeah!
And he thinks on stage, at this stage in his life, with an expensive mortgage and a pensive wife. His youngest son, Alfie, says, what's it all about? If he had any hair left, he'd pull it out. His teenage son said, His dad taught him to play piano, but he didn't live to see his son at the famous theatre performing on TV. If he didn't see it through, imagine how sad the look on the faces of both his lads, who always tell him, you're the greatest showman, Dad. They'll see me on BGT, no more third person, just Daddy, this is me.
Everything, and at the end he had us moved to tears. This show is perfect for you, and now I want to see you go as far as you can in this competition.
Wow.
Well done.
Feel yourself. John, it was just a wonderful audition. You're somebody who's worked for years, needs a break. You'll get a huge reaction of this, I promise you. And we all want you to do well. So I would love to be the first to say yes.
Next up tonight is a truly incredible performer who also happens to be our Golden Buzzer act. It's the brilliant John Courtney.
Well done, good boy, well done.
Since Dad first taught me how to play and I learnt my first song from the jokes that I began to write and the nights they went so wrong from an audience of five or six to driving home alone finding a love that understood and having children of my own. Just a bit of fun when my youngest son said,
give yourself a chance.
But never thought I'd be on BGT. I'm not a dog and I can't dance. In the Palladium, an ovation in front of my kids and wife. Anton Deck changed my life. And now I'm standing in the wings with all the excitement that it brings, still finding gold confetti in my things. My future's on stage when I sing. It's been a long time coming, and this is my career. It's the chance that I've been waiting for, hoping for all these years, and now it's here. So push down the fear. I need a hug, but no one can come near.
Hello, good evening. Hi, it's amazing to be here, obviously. So for my audition, I sung a song about my kids and about being a dad. And tonight I want to take you back a bit further to when I was a kid and about my mum and dad. I've written a song called When I Was a Boy. We have a photo of when I was a boy. This is me when I was about three. I know, I'm the one on the right. But I did meet a very rich lady after my audition at the London Palladium, and she'd spent a lot of money to try and look like the one on the left. Here we are again for some more BGT. Never dreamed the semis would include me. How could this be real? It must be a hoax. I'm just a piano man with a bunch of bad dad jokes. My hamster died. He fell asleep at the wheel. Yeah. We've got a virtual audience for the semi, and you at home watching on TV. We were one judge down, so thanks, Ashley. Cycling for Simon is unhealthy. Electrically, apparently. As for me, I was outside Tesco 2 meters apart. Hand sanitizer, gloves and a mask. So I was unrecognizable for people to ask. Were you on BGT? It's a pain in the ask me why I do this, then they understood. Inspiration from Chaplin to Victoria Wood. As a child, I saw variety shows on the screen, wanting to be Billy Connolly, Elton or Queen. My hair no longer grows, just out my ears and out my nose. My forehead now has met my neck. But no forehead jokes in front of Anton Deck. And Deck go together like Robin and Batman, like Phil and Holly, like Simon and Fake Tan. But the greatest double act the world ever had was Carolyn and Ivan. That's my mum and dad. They were on stage long before I was born. As a child, I would sit there just shouting for more. They'd take me backstage, naked dancers I'd see.
I decided show business was the business for me. For 45 years they were barely apart, but there wasn't a day when I didn't hear them laugh. Like when Dad dropped a glass of chocolate milk in the bath. When we saw the mess, he said, I only meant to fart. Dad was still laughing till his final bow, and the memories of him make us laugh even now. Mum said never give up, and she knows I love her, but even she never dreamed I'd get a golden buzzer. My children have watched me from their youngest age bring music and laughter from up on the stage. Just like I watched my mum and her dreams come true now. She gets to be on TV virtually. Mum, take a bow. Your family may be crazy, they may drive you round the bend. Your kids may drive you insane, it's a never-ending spend. But my mum always told me, be proud of who you are. So now I tell my children, always reach for the stars. Moments in your life don't get much bigger than this. It's a milestone like a wedding or a teenager's first kiss. But to be here in the final is feeling slightly odd. It's champagne and caviar. I'm used to Vimto and battered cod. And though this moment overwhelms me, the question must be asked, do we sometimes miss the small things as life goes by so fast? Mosquitoes are only tiny, but they can drive you mad. So never underestimate small things that make you glad. Simon makes David happy, and he'll be there when he calls. He burst into his dressing room and realized it's just small things. The last shoes in the sale being the right size for you. A baby's expression when they're having a poo. Looking in the junk drawer and finding a pen. Fitting a size 8 when you were usually a 10. My wife told me that. Small things that make you happy. Small things that make you laugh. Bubbles make kids giggle when they're trumping in the bath. Aardvarks are happy when it's alphabetical. Dogs will always wag their tails if they can lick their ball games. Make kids happy when they're playing, having fun. I wasn't happy when the schools closed and I had to teach my sons. I was happy when Boris told me I could finally hug my mum. But I was happiest in April, finding loo roll for my bum. Ant and Dec are happy when they take home an award. So they've been pretty happy since 1994. I know your first award was in 1995, but that didn't rhyme.
Okay.
You got to seize the moment, you just live once, I hear you say. But that's not true, you die once, but you must live every day. Smile as if they've told you there's no need to quarantine. When you laugh in denim, happiness is in your genes. Happiness is small things like being with our friends. Little things like when the Queen said we'll meet again. On Thursdays on our doorsteps with pride inside our chests. Taking just a moment to clap the NHS. And it won't be long before these masks are gone. We'll be living life again to the maximum. And we'll remember people like Sir Captain Tom. And in years, our kids will be reminiscing, not about the big stuff that they've been missing, but that every day they got to play with Dad and Mum. And we'll remember that we were strong when McDonald's was closed for so very long. And Britain's talent will be that we all carry on. And Britain's talent will be that we all carry on. To be here now, to get this far, for you to make me feel like a star. For gratitude, I don't know where to start. When Alfie asked me, what's it all about? I thought I knew, but I had my doubts. But the answer is so simple and so smart. You'll realize through it all, the moments that you thought were small can take the biggest places in your heart. And if you're lucky, your family plays the biggest part.
My youngest is 9 years old, and he writes a letter to Santa every year. So I had an idea of writing a song that's basically reading the letter that my son's written to Santa. It's very true to what I believe Christmas is about, which is about being kind to people. That's the whole idea of the song. Kindness isn't just for Christmas. Yeah.
Dear Santa and your elves, and the reindeer that pull your sleigh, lots of people have been poorly, so I hope that you're okay. I've sanitized the chimney, Rudolph's carrot has been steamed, your glass of milk is pasteurized, so you know that it's clean. This year has been a weird one for so many of my friends. I've heard people in my family say they wish that it would end. But every year I make a wish before you visit me. I'd rather see some snow outside than gifts under the tree. But what we all thought was normal seems so long ago. So I wanted to write and say it's all right if there isn't any snow. There are lots of things at Christmas every year I want to see, like the sound of music or Mary Poppins repeated on TV. Always want Michael Bublé rocking round a Christmas tree, and all we want for Christmas is more Mariah Carey. What we don't need to see is Uncle Bob on the sofa as he snores, or Mum have one more sherry, Auntie tutting as she pours. Dad's expression when he's given another pair of socks, or my sister say, this time next year I promise to detox. But Christmas isn't quantified by the presents that we get or buy, and it isn't really classified by how much John Lewis makes us cry. And if you ever had any doubts, it's definitely not in Brussels sprouts. What Christmas is all about is kindness, that's what stands out. Be kind to those who are mean and cross, the ones you think are gross. I guarantee you'll live to see they're the ones that need it most. So even though my wish for snow is usually ignored, kindness is a gift that everybody can afford. Maybe the message that seems to have missed us, just like a puppy, kindness isn't just for Christmas. We've all seen so much sadness since this virus came about, but we've also seen the good things, and I'm not left in any doubt. As I sit here and make my wish this year, I'm happy just to know, if people are kind, then I won't mind if there isn't any snow. But maybe we'll find we can be kind and the snow stays. still gets to blow.
Biggest thanks of all go to you at home for watching. We'll be back with a new series next year, but for now, good night. And from all of us here at Britain's Got Talent, Merry Christmas,
Merry
everybody!
Christmas!
For Christmas.